Well, hi guys. My name's Tim Gardner, and I'm a gastroenterologist who specializes in the pancreas. And I've been here at Dartmouth for about 15 years. And what I want to do is talk to you about a project I've done, which I think is really, really interesting. And it involves taking people's pancreases out of their body, grinding it up, isolating the cells in the pancreas, and then putting those cells back into the patient's body in the liver. So the most important thing you guys need to know is that I love the pancreas, okay? I love the pancreas. And I'm hoping to convince you as well that this would be something that you would like to fund and sponsor. So let me give you a little bit of background about the pancreas. So the pancreas is a gland that sits in the body right in the middle of the abdomen. It's about 6 inches in size. And it has two basic functions. The first is that it helps digest food. So without a pancreas, one can't digest their food very well. And the second thing it does is it helps make hormones or chemicals that helps you to your body to function properly. And the most important chemical it makes is insulin. So people who have a problem with their pancreas don't have enough insulin in their body and they develop diabetes. So for the body to work properly, it's really important to have a well-functioning pancreas. Unfortunately, there are several diseases that can cause the pancreas to get damaged, actually cause the pancreas to die. And when that happens, the term we use is something called pancreatitis. So there are many patients who are walking around with inflammation of their pancreas that has caused their pancreas to die. And as a result, the pancreas doesn't function well, they have a hard time digesting their food, and sometimes even develop diabetes. The reason why I'm talking to you today is to talk to you about a procedure that we do here at Dartmouth, one of the very few places in the world that actually does this procedure to help patients who have this problem. So, when certain patients have difficulties in their pancreas, when their pancreas is so inflamed that it's not working well, we can give medications, we can try various lifestyle modifications, but the only thing that cures some of these people is to take out their pancreas. To have an operation, it's about a 10-hour operation, the pancreas comes out. That's something that's done throughout the country. Many centers will go ahead and have a pancreas taken out. What's interesting here, what we do so uniquely as one of the few places in the world, is that when we determine that someone needs to have their pancreas taken out, we don't just take it out and throw it away. Instead, what we do is we take out the good parts of the pancreas, we isolate those parts out. Those are called islet cells, and the islet cells are what are responsible for controlling patients' blood sugars. So we take out the pancreas, we isolate out the islet cells, take those out, throw the bad part of the pancreas away, that's not helpful, and we take those cells, isolate them, and put them, as I said, back in the patient's liver. And the idea behind this is to basically grow a pancreas within the patient's liver and prevent them from getting diabetes. And you probably say, this is absolutely insane. Like, you're actually growing a pancreas in someone's liver, and you say, how could anybody do that? Have you done that? Well, I can tell you that we've done it many times here at Dartmouth. We've done it about, at this point, about 65 times. And we've done this in patients as young as 16 years old, patients who have not able to go to school, who are in chronic pain, who are completely debilitated by their symptoms, and we've saved their lives and allowed them to be functioning members of society. So the youngest person we've done this procedure in is age 16. The oldest we've done is age 68. And as I said, we've done this about 65 times. The reason I'm here is because I want the ability to perfect how we isolate out those islet cells. So you say, how do you do this? Well, how we do it is we go to the operating room, we take out the pancreas, and over a period of about 4 hours, we instill all sorts of chemicals, enzymes, we mash the pancreas up, and we put it in this device right here. This is called a Ricordi chamber. The pancreas actually goes into this chamber, and it shakes, you can hear that. It shakes around for about an hour and a half, and as we digest out the pancreas, we actually take out the cells that are good, these islet cells, and we make an infusion of these islet cells, basically a bag of cells. And after we've done this for about 4 hours and gotten those cells, we then place a little catheter, a little tube, into the vein that feeds the liver, and we instill those cells into the patient's liver. So that when we take out their pancreas, immediately they're diabetic. 4 hours later, we put those cells back in the pancreas, and they do not become a diabetic. So the reason I'm here is to try to get funding to help perfect this process, to perfect the process of how we isolate out the islet cells. currently we're really good at it. We're really, really good at it. About 70 to 80% of our patients who have this procedure do not develop diabetes. They do really, really well. I'm here to ask you to help me with those last 20 to 30% of patients. What I want to be able to do is do experiments on these islet cells, on the process, to figure out what's going to be the best way to fix these patients. This is something we're already doing here, and I've had patients come as far as Indiana, I've had patients come from California, I've had a patient who's going to be coming from South Africa, and we've done patients all throughout New England and New York to help with this, to try to fix this problem. And so, again, the funding that I'm asking for is to help make this a better process. What kind of enzyme formulation, chemicals do I use to digest the pancreas? How long do I digest the pancreas? What temperature do I put the pancreas on? These are all experiments. Because this is so novel, I need help to try to figure out how to do this. So what I'd like to do is a series of experiments starting in pigs. That's how we perfected this process initially, starting in pigs to try to do experiments on those to see how we can perfect it. And then what I'd like to do is have funding to obtain rejected pancreas transplant samples. So people who have donated their bodies after death, many of those pancreas transplants aren't used because the pancreases are damaged. So we can obtain those pancreases, work on those so we can actually perfect our technique in humans. And then bring this to the human side of it so that we can actually do this procedure and perfect it. So again, this is something that we're already doing, and we have lots of patients who are coming for this, traveling really throughout the world to come to little old Lebanon, New Hampshire to have this done. But I'd like to make this better. I'd like to be able to tell every patient, you have a 100% chance of not getting diabetes after this procedure, and not just an 80% chance. So that's why I'm here to pitch this to you. I think it's a really unique program that we're doing. It combines both the basic sciences in the lab, but it also directly correlates to our patients here at Dartmouth and beyond. So thank you very much for listening to my pitch.
Dr. Gardner, you've been doing this for a little while here, and I remember when you started doing this originally, you were sending the islet cells off to Boston to be processed out. Are you doing that here now?
So we used to send our islets to Boston because they had an islet cell lab. Mm-hmm. We did that for about 2 years, and all the logistical issues that you can imagine, transporting a pancreas there and back from Boston to have this done. The folks in Boston, it was a basic science lab. They did not do this procedure there. So we decided about 4 years ago now that we needed to have a lab here, and we've done that. We've perfected the lab. So for the last 3 years, we've been doing all of our patients here at Dartmouth. It's all doing here. What I want to do is now take what we're doing and make it even better.
So to get to that next 20%, what kind of commitment are you looking for to get to your research to where it needs to be?
That's great. I think what we're probably looking for is between $700,000 and $800,000. Because what I need to do is obtain those pig pancreases, obtain those human rejected pancreases, and use the chemicals and various machinery to get that to happen.
This is fascinating work that you're doing, and congratulations to you and your team that you've been saving so many people's lives and making their lives better. So my question for you is, what does success look like 5 to 10 years from now? So it's great that people are coming from all over the world to Lebanon, New Hampshire, but do you foresee this spreading to other medical centers? Like, what do you see as the next step after you perfect this to help the other 20 to 30%?
It's a great question. Thank you for asking. So yes, I mean, what I look at success is, first of all, get to that 100% number, or as close as we can to be able to give people that opportunity. We've already had teams come here to study this. We recently had a group from Belgium who flew here to evaluate our technique to see how we do it because it's so novel. So what I'd like to do is make this more widespread, and I think if we can perfect the technique, we'll be able to make it more widespread throughout the country so that everyone doesn't have to travel to New Hampshire to get this done. They can go to their local centers to have it done as well. So that would be an ideal situation for us and how we define success in the future.
Yeah. Well, congratulations. This was really terrific, and thank you for being with us.
Great. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.